At this point, all we need is the core file. So if you remember, I got rid of the complete GCC, which had other languages in, and the test suite. And all we've got is the core and G++, which is all we need. But at this point, all we need is the core file. So we'll extract that GCC core. Now, it says it's going to take about 10 times an SPU, so roughly 20 minutes or so. And there's an issue with this package in that it won't compile with the bin utils version, which is 2.91, is that right? Sources, yeah, 2.91. It doesn't actually build with that, so what we've got to do is to try and convince GCC to use the statically built version that we've got, which is 2.13, so at least four versions newer. So what I did, I actually rebuilt binutils and put it in the main directory, but I think I can get away with just using the static version. Yeah, I've got a note here, this actually takes an hour and a half to build. So interestingly, yeah, that's way off the 20 minutes as the SPU states that it'll take to build, but let's see how it goes anyway, especially as I'm going to do it slightly differently. So what I'm going to do is put the two patches in, first of all. So let's have a look at them. We've got nofix includes two. Yes, I've named them the same, but I would have regenerated these or copied them. In fact, I think most, if not all of these, I've put comments in at the top so you can actually get an idea of where they've come from. So it looks like I've fixed that one. And that looks like that's something I've copied either from Linux from Scratch 5 or something I've got off the internet. Probably from Linux from Scratch, that one. A later version, possibly. So let's put the both patches in. I'll do these one at a time to make sure that they actually apply correctly in case they don't like the last one. So once again, I'm going to have to put the full path of patch in, as it's not installed properly yet. So that's going to be LFS, static, bin, and patch. So that one's worked okay. And the other one I want is this one here. And yes, that's worked okay as well. So let's create the temporary build directory and change into it. And then what I've got to do is to modify the path. So I'm going to do path equals, and then I want /mnt LFS static /bin. And then the current path to be added in to find anything else in the basis. And so what I've done is I've said search for anything that we've built statically first. So it should pick up like things like AR and AS because they're the been built by the bin utils. So if I show you AR on the system, or AS, which I believe is the assembler, I'm not sure what AR is, but they're both part of bin utils. You can say they both say 2.91, whereas if I run, say, AS as part of the static build that we did, you can see that's 2.13, which is the newer version of bin utils, which is what we want. So that's why I've done that. The first search path will be the static version we've built, and then if it can't find anything there, which will be a lot of the stuff on the host system, it goes and uses the current path variable to find those. Then I should be able to copy this configure command in, and that should work like that. Okay, and then we've got to add this extra option to this file here. And then we build it with this command here. Now, usually, once you've set any extra parameters on the configure commands, they should be retained for the build. But because this is a package that takes a while to build, I'm not going to take a chance and have it potentially break. What I'm going to do is just keep this path option here so that it just asserts the fact that I do want to use that path and build it with that. So that'll be used with make. And I'll probably do the same for install, although I'm almost certain that install wouldn't need it, but you never know. So let's get that going and wait for that to finish building. As I say, that I think took 97 minutes here to compile when I tested this, so let's see how long it takes now. Okay, so that has taken about an hour and a half. So what I'm going to do now is to install it. And I'll retain that path to the... basically to use the newer bin utils. So I'll just paste that in and that should install it. So then we'll have a newer GCC available in the static build, ready for building the proper LFS version 4.0. And create that symlink. So that's tidy up.